for Tampa Bay. The shortstop, Wander Franco,
and he deals down the middle for a strike, and we're underway here in the home opener. That misses, and the count even 1-1. Jack swing went around. Going to count 1-2. And down on strikes. One up, one down. Up to the plate steps DJ LeMahieu. First pitch, and he just misses. And it's 1-1. LeMahieu checks his swing. Now an appeal to first. He did not go around. The 2-1. Swing and a miss. And it's 2-2. The next pitch misses. And the count is filled up. Now fly ball to right center. Peterson on his way over makes the grab on the run, and there's two away. And up to the plate comes Cody Bellinger,
the center fielder, number 35. Cody Bellinger,
and he swings and misses at the initial offering. Next one misses, ball one. No score, just getting started, top of the first. Up the middle, a dive, nice stop. And that's a nice play to end the inning. Bottom of the first, digging in, Tommy Edman.
Leading up for the Diamondback, the second baseman.
The pitch.
Tommy.
That's in there, and it's 0-1. Right side, Lau picks it up, gathers, and throws to first. One gone, bottom half of the first. Here's Ketel Marte.
Not shortstop. Ketel Marte.
Rooker right there to make the grab. Two away now. Max Muncy at the dish. This is another guy capable of hitting tape measure home runs.
Muncy.
And that one hit to first. He'll do it himself. And that is the third out of the inning. Top of the second, and now it's Salvador Perez to the plate.
Leading off for the Rays, the catcher, number 13, Salvador Perez.
The pitch. And a foul ball. Right-hander kicks, deals. And a count 1-2. And a pitch. And it's fouled away. The pitch. Got him. And there's one away. And the batter now is Joey Votto.
The designated hitter, Joey Votto.
Swings through that one. 0-1. And there's a foul ball. Next pitch is downstairs.
Well, he's not afraid to fall into a two-strike count. Knows the strike zone very well, so much so that I think umpires will look at him and determine whether it's a ball or strike, if he swings or not.
One down, base is empty. That one is absolutely belted. And that's up onto the walkway and out of here. Joey Votto pops one out of here. And they jump out front. It's 1-0. Base is empty, one away. Joey Gallo steps to the plate.
Batting fifth, the right fielder, number 13.
And fouled Joey off.
Gallo.
Oh, and 2 as he waves at that one.
Okay.
Here's a tapper towards short. Marte handles. On to first. And they take care of Gallo for the out. And now it's switch hitting third baseman Abraham Toro. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Kicks and deals. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. The pitch. And a swing and a miss. And that's that. And welcome back. And now it's Bobby Bradley. And Chris, probably no other player better represents present-day baseball than this guy. A lot of power, a lot of strikeouts, and some walks. Line drive. Toss to LeMahieu. They go 5-3 for the first out as the third baseman makes the play from the shortstop spot in the shift. And now Jack Peterson. Fly ball down the line. Racing makes the catch. And there's two down.
Well, those can be pretty fun as an outfielder. Got to put it into his highest gear and go a long way to track that one down. Nothing better than that. You feel like a wide receiver playing football.
On the ground, right side. Lau sends it to first, and Hicks is out. Inning over. Top half of the third inning. Here's a big power threat. Brandon Lau.
Leading off for Tampa Bay, the second baseman.
The right-hander back to work.
Wow.
And first offering is fouled off. Little bouncer out in front of the plate to first, and one away at the top of the third. So digging in, Brent Rooker.
The left Rooker.
Out towards left center. And that's a base hit. So now back to the top of the order.
Went up there looking to be aggressive and got something he could handle. Good job getting the foot down so he could catch it out front and pull it. Turned on it nicely for the knock.
Now batting Wander Franco. In the first pitch, misses for ball one. And it's even up.
Spin rate's outstanding on that high fastball. Really tough to hit.
And a pitch. Down and in, moved his feet. Rooker over at first with one away. Next pitch misses. Three balls and a strike. And he walked him. One down. Now it's LeMahieu up to him. And he swings and misses, and it's nothing at one. And that chance handled. Quick feed to second for one. Over to first. That's two. Nicely done. 1-6-3. Welcome back. Bottom of the inning. And now it is JT Realmuto.
The catcher.
The wind and the pitch. That one fouled off. Next offering is fouled back. And there's one away.
Boy, that was a hanging breaking ball right there. I think he tried to do a little bit too much. Sometimes those eyes can get really big. I think his swing broke down as well, and that's what caused him to pop it up.
Eugenio Suarez comes up empty with a swing there. Batting here with one away. Next offering is down low.
Boog, it looks like somebody missed the swing sign. That's the first pitch this team's taken for a ball all game long.
And it is 2-1.
Last couple of pitches, breaking balls away. I think he's going to have to come firm inside to be able to open up that location if he wants to go back there later in this count.
Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk. Man at first with one gone. Jorge Soler up at the plate.
No left fielder. Jorge.
In there for strike one. Meanwhile, this pitch gets away. Home team down a run. The Rays leading on the solo homer. The next offering misses. 2-1. Double play ball to second. The tag, and he's out. And that is the inning. Back here in the desert, start of the fourth, leading off Cody Bellinger.
Leading off for Tampa Bay. The center field, number 35.
Keller back to work. Bellinger. And first offering is fouled off. Kicks and fires. Fought off foul. In the air, left field. Soler makes the grab. And a quick out, number one. Pretty good job on the mound in this one, Siggy. It feels like we've seen a lot of off-balance swings.
Yep, just one free pass, and obviously he's not a big strikeout guy, but he gets soft contact and he gets outs.
0-1 down. And a strike. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And now two gone. And next is the designated hitter, Joey Votto. Swing and a high fly ball to left. Soler settles underneath it. Makes the grab, and that's the inning. Back here at the ballpark, here's the second baseman, Tommy Edman.
Leading up for the Diamondback.
The line and the pitch.
Tommy Edman.
Gallo makes the grab. One pitch and one out. Ketel Marte up to the plate.
Number four. Shortstop. Ketel Marte.
And that's in there for strike one. The D-backs hitless so far in the game. Foul ball there. The 0-2 stays alive. Out towards right center field. Gallo makes his way towards it. Puts it away for the out. Two outs, base is empty. Here's Max Muncy, that funky Muncy.
Max Muncy.
And he swings and misses at the initial offering. Next pitch inside. One ball, one strike. The Diamondbacks yet to pick up a hit here. Strike two. Next pitch is in the dirt, and the count is even, 2-2. And that one handled. Tosses to first. They get the out on Muncy. That ends the inning. Ready now for the fifth inning. Now up for Tampa Bay, Joey Gallo.
Leading off for the Rays, the right fielder.
The right hander back to work.
Joey.
That one ran inside, almost got him. He swings and fouls one off. Left-hand batter waits. So now 1-2.
Well, there's a certain point where you have to commit to what you think you see, and he guessed wrong right there. Nasty slider with just terrific bite at the end.
Got him. And the leadoff hitter retired in the fifth. Here's the third baseman, Abraham Toro.
Abraham Toro.
And first offering is fouled off. And he's down 0-2 as he swings through it. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him. And now it's Brandon Lau.
Second baseman, Brandon Lau.
First pitch, not close. Swing and a line drive, base hit out of the center field. And that keeps the inning going.
I'm sure he feels really good about that one. These days, when you see a ball come off the bat like that, the first thing you want to know as a spectator, what was the exit velocity? 109 in this case. I mean, that's just impressive. And it's so cool we can get that sort of feedback so instantly in today's game.
The 0-1 is outside, and it's a ball and a strike. They say it went.
One ball, two strikes.
Swing and a miss, and that is that. Back here at Chase Field, we head to the bottom of the fifth at the plate. Bobby Bradley.
The designated hitter.
Here comes a pitch.
Bradley.
Foul ball.
He's been pitching well, but going through this middle of the order second time through, we'll see what kind of adjustments are being made.
Puts it in the air out towards left center. Rooker glides back and puts the squeeze on that. And there's one down. And Jock Peterson stands in.
Next to the Diamondbacks, the right fielder.
Rooker makes the grab, and there are two down. It's Aaron Hicks now.
The center fielder, Aaron Hicks.
Lifted in the air, right center field. Bellinger under it. He's got it, and that'll end the inning. And welcome back. Stepping in is the switch hitting shortstop, Wander Franco.
Leading off for the Rays, the shortstop, Wander Franco.
And he deals. Swing and a miss, and that is strike one. Next offering is downstairs. Next one is off the play, and it's 2-1.
Boy, he put good velocity in the head of the hitter. He's got to get it ready early and then change speeds. Keep him off balance. That's the goal.
Now a high fly ball out to left center. Hicks on the move. Puts it away for the out. Here's DJ LeMahieu.
The first baseman, DJ.
Chad Green ready to go. He's being eased into the game here with the bases empty.
Well, at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and he needs a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
In there, and it's 0-1. And the righty deals. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And two away now. Two outs. Base is empty. Cody Bellinger next to hit for the Rays.
Bellinger.
That one's in there. 0-1. Next one in the dirt. Next offering is in for a strike. Next one just misses, and it's 2-2. Got it. And that is that. Welcome back. Bottom of the sixth. Stepping in, JT Realmuto.
Leading off for the Diamondbacks.
Marquez back to work.
JT.
That one's in there. It's 0-1.
It really looks like these hitters have been in between with their timing today. Good fastball, excellent slider, but they've not been able to commit to one velocity and stay there.
Next one is off the plate. Yeah, that's ball two. Pitch misses there, and the count is 3-1.
Expect for that guy to come right at you with a fastball, something in the zone, because he does not want to allow the leadoff ball. Well, he tried to nibble right there and just missed his spot. Hitter didn't offer at it. Now he has somebody to worry about over at first.
The third baseman, Eugenio
Suarez, in the box now, takes strike one.
Tonight, his slider has been really impressive. I mean, tight spin. Seems like the hitters aren't picking it up out of the hand.
Safe. He beats it. Realmuto aboard here at first with nobody out. Out into left center for a line drive base hit. And it gets by him. And that'll pick off the base of the wall. Realmuto headed for the plate. He scores to tie it up. It's 1-1. The throw to third, and he's out trying for three. Here's the left fielder, Jorge Soler.
Now that's left fielder, Jorge
Soler. First offering misses the mark. Next offering misses. Two balls, no strikes to count. And the pitch. Slapped foul. The wind of the pitch. On the ground to third. Toss to LeMahieu. And there's two down. Tommy Edman at the plate.
The batter number 19. Second baseman, Tommy Edman.
Bunting for a hit. And that's a bunt single. That was placed perfectly. Two outs, runner at first. An outstanding hitter in Ketel Marte. Here comes the pitch. Runner breaks for second. And first offering is fouled off. Marquez over to first. He's in there. pitch. That one missed.
Good speed on the base pass. He handles the bat very well. I wouldn't be surprised if the skipper puts on some type of hit and run or a run and hit.
This looks like extra bases. Edmund rounds third, headed for the plate. Oh, the throw is wild.
Couple of hits in a row for him here. Now a huge at bat in this game coming up.
Here comes Max Muncy.
Now batting, the first baseman.
Yeah, I'm surprised we didn't see a visit from the pitching coach here. Just to remind him, focus on the hitter. Don't worry about anything else.
Two on, two outs. Check swing, and that's a ball.
These home fans, they are making a lot of noise, putting pressure on that pitcher out there.
Move to second. In there. He's safe. Righty delivers. That misses the zone. 3-0. Appears they're working around him with the base open, Singy.
Well, you know these 2-0 counts, Boo. They're just not what they used to be, and we sound like old guys when I say that. But ultimately, this is a strategic game, and you expect to see this type of approach by the pitcher in this situation.
Base hit. One run is in. Another scores. Two runs in on the play, and they lead by two.
Didn't take long to get a result for that at bat. That's a good sound coming off the bat, man. And as he connected out front and lifted into the outfield, that's one of those swings where you just don't even feel the ball hit.
Peterson swings. Mashes one deep to right, and that ball is gone. Jack Peterson bops one out, and they add to their lead. It's 6-1. Aaron Hicks at the plate.
Now back, the center fielder, Aaron
Hicks. That one lifted to left, and now maybe extra bases. Around first and hustling for second, and it's a leadoff double as they look to keep pulling away. And now, JT Realmuto. Known for his rocket arm behind the plate.
The catcher, JT Realmuto.
Ground ball off the middle. That's a base hit. Hicks around third.
Well, no waiting around right there. He was ready to swing it on the first pitch. Take notes on that swing, kids. That was a really nice breaking ball on the low outside corner, and he did all you can do with that pitch. He dropped the barrel down to it, stayed inside it with his hands, and just slapped it hard the opposite way.
Hey, Eugenio Suarez up to hit down. Franco gloves it. They get the force, and that will end the inning. Back here in the desert, top of inning number 7. And now the catcher for the Rays, Salvador Perez.
Number 13, Salvador Perez.
The pitch. And a foul ball. Right-handed reliever. And that one is lifted in the air. He can't get there. It's a base hit. They're still chasing it as he rounds second. And he gets there. The tying runs at third with a triple.
When you pop a ball up like that, you don't expect it to get you a knock too often. But right there, somehow he got it to drop in behind first base, and that's where no one can get to it.
Votto, the next to hit, takes ball one. Perez at third with nobody out. Next pitch misses inside. Two balls, no strikes. They've got a potent lineup. And when you think about teams capable of rallying from this kind of deficit, they're right at the top of the list. Righty to the plate. Fouls one off. 2-2. Swings and misses. One gone here. Here's Joey Gallo.
Up next for Tampa Bay, the right fielder, Joey Gallo.
Hard hit, right side. Oh, look at the stop. And very nicely done for the out.
Now back.
Two outs, base is empty. Abraham Toro now at the plate. Swings through that one. 0-1. Toro tries to check his swing. Now a look to third. And Matthew Ross right on it, says he held up. And a count 1-2.
Look out. That ball was smoked. Man, I am so relieved that they have this netting down the lines. Just ensures safety for the fans. Last thing as a player you want to look up at.
Well struck right field. And into the pole. It's out of here. Abraham Toro blasts one out. And they inch closer. It's 7-3. Lau at the plate. Connor Green gets handed the rock out of the pen. He's into the game with the bases empty.
Wow. Your attention, please. Now picking for the diamond. Number 81.
Check swing, but he went too far. 0-1. That one misses in the dirt. Swing and a miss. And a count 1-2. And down on strikes he goes, and that'll do it. Back here at the ballpark, ready to go for the last half of the inning. Now the left fielder, Jorge Soler.
The left fielder, Jorge Soler. Ladies and gentlemen, your attention please. Now picking for the play, number 48, J.D. Wendell.
And here it comes. And that one fouled off. Toss to LeMahieu. And the leadoff hitter set down to open the seventh.
Deceptive slider right there. Stayed in the tunnel a long time. Got that hitter out front. Rolled over it. Put it on the ground.
Edmund.
Now at the plate as he swings through strike one.
A lot of times you'll see a pitcher maybe double up on a pitch. This guy will throw it three times, four times in a row because hitters just can't lay off of it.
And the 0-2. And a foul ball. He stays alive. At the belt and fires. Stays alive. That one ripped. And a base hit right there. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
Nice line drive to the full side. Met it out front, but just stayed through it nice enough and ripped it into the outfield.
Now here is Ketel Marte. And the first offering is not close. And a 1-1. There's the swing and a miss.
Good late sink on that fastball. Out of the hand looks so good. And then by the time it gets in the hitting zone, hard to get the barrel to it.
Rooker gliding to his left. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. Out number two. And now it's Max Muncy.
Now down. The first baseman.
And first offering is fouled off. And the right-hander deals. That's a laser base hit. Lead runner gets the stop sign at third. It's a two-out double, second and third now. So two down, and next will be the cleanup hitter, Bobby Bradley.
The batter, number 44. Designated hitter, Bobby Bradley.
The tag, and that's out number three, inning over. Back here at Chase Field, here's the left fielder, Brent Rooker.
Leading off for Tampa Bay, the left fielder, Brent Rooker. Your attention, please.
In today's game, you look at exit velocity as a measure of process, and if guys are hitting the ball hard, eventually the results usually follow. Gary Sanchez, he is a guy that hits the ball hard. Gary Sanchez at the plate. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Next one misses, ball two. Way inside, gets out of the way. And there's ball four.
It's tough after falling behind a hitter, two balls and no strikes, but now at least he gets a fresh start against a new batter, but he needs to get back into the strike zone and start pitching with conviction.
Your attention, please. Now running at first base for the game, number 11, Nico Goodrich.
And that one hammered way back there. And out of here. That'll fire up the dugout, and they close the gap. It's 7-5. And now it's DJ LeMahieu digging in.
Now batting, the first baseman.
That first offering is fouled off.
Can be tough to bounce back after a big home run, but nobody on, nobody out. You just have to treat it as a fresh inning.
Next offering is in for a strike. Swing and a miss. And he's down on strikes. And that's the first out. One down. Here comes Cody Bellinger.
Cody Bellinger.
And he swings and misses, and it's nothing at all. Next pitch inside, 1-1. Left-hand hitter waits. Swing and a miss. And that is strike two. Next pitch is outside, 2-2. Right-hander kicks, deals, and now it's filled up.
At this point in the game, you cannot issue free passes. He's going to have to challenge this hitter. Hitter's got to be ready to swing it.
Line drive, base hit.
Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly.
Here comes Mark Melancon, and he'll do his best to hang on to this lead. And the batter now, Salvador Perez. And he swings and misses at the initial offering.
Now this guy's definitely looking for a big swing of the bat right here. Try to close that gap. But, you know, at the very least, if you could find a way to manufacture that run from first, it feels like it's really important to getting back into this ballgame.
The tying run at the plate. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. Yeah, there's two away. So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Joey Votto. He's already homered in this game. And first offering is fouled off. Bellinger leads off first with two down to the inning. Popped up to the left into foul ground. Suarez makes the catch, and that'll do it. On to the bottom of the eighth. And now the DH, Bobby Bradley.
Leading up for the Diamondbacks, the designated hitter, Bobby Bradley.
And a pitch. Swing and a miss. Strike one.
I think he was a little excited there. Saw the fastball, but needed a stepladder to get to that one. He's going to have to tighten it back up. He wants to have a good at bat.
Bradley waits. Bellinger settles under it. And puts the squeeze on that one. And there's one down. Here's Jack Peterson.
Now batting, right fielder, Jack Peterson.
This one chopped on the ground, but foul. And a pitch. There's a swing and a drive. That's back. Pulls it in on the warning track. Here's Aaron Hicks.
Now batting, center fielder, Aaron Hicks.
And that one wrapped foul. Two outs. Check swing, tried to hold up. Now an appeal to third. And Matthew Ross right on it, says he held up. Two down, nobody on. Gets him to chase after that one.
Filthy changeup right there. Just pulled the string.
The next pitch misses. Counts full, 3-2. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Boom. Do you think you could draw a walk in the bigs if we gave you enough at-bats?
Oh, that's a good question.
I think that if they gave the pitcher a full scouting report on me, yes, I think I could draw a walk. To third, Toro picks it up. And that is that. And welcome back. And now it's Joey Gallo. He is very much your typical power hitter. I'd say he falls into the three true outcomes category.
But we've seen more and more of that lately. The ability to drive the ball to slug is getting heavily favored over any discipline or strikeout concerns.
Hit pretty well in the air out to center. Hicks is there for it. Makes the grab, one away. Now the third baseman, Abraham Toro. And first offering is fouled off. The pitch. Just missed. That one to first. Muncy steps on the bag. Two up, two down. Brandon Lau will hit next. He has, as they like to say, like tower power. Not a big guy, but a big swing. And thunder in that bat. So out of the pen for the Diamondbacks, James Karinchak. Trying to protect this lead. And first offering is fouled off. Next pitch is downstairs. On the ground, right side. And that is the ball game.
Well, a three-pitch save. This guy might feel cheated a little bit. Gets in the ball game, wants to show off his arsenal, and really didn't get that opportunity. But I think he'll take it. Whenever you can get that save and do it efficiently, he'll be ready to pitch tomorrow.
A 7-5 final score in this one. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi saying so long. Dice que soltera.